Cancel culture is something that these entitled weak shits think is what can stop us from doing what we are good at. Toni Gonzaga is an amazing mother. She is a devoted wife. She's a good daughter. Good. And I know this because I went to school with Kathy. We graduated from the same university. She graduated EDUC. I graduated IMC. So you can imagine that all those years that Toni is already Toni G, Kathy had just, you know, barely started bursting into the scene of show business. And what I know about them is that they're the kind of people who were raised on the premise to not care about everybody else, except that they were good people. So when you try to cancel people like that, it's futile and useless. Wala kaming pakialam kung makakancel kami kasi hindi kami subscription sa cable network o sa cellphone. When you say cancel Toni G for not sharing your thoughts and aligning with your political beliefs, una sa lahat, why didn't you cancel her in 2016 nung sinuportahan nila ni Paul Soriano si BBM for vice president? Why didn't you cancel her then when they made BBM their ninong? I mean, ganyan ba talaga kayo kawalang alam? O ganyan lang talaga kayo ka-entitled thinking na may power pa kayo over us? I say us because I've been canceled more times than Toni G. Bago pa lang siya, girl. Ako, one whole year na niya akong kinakancel. Buhay pa rin us. And funny how, despite kung gaano kagaling si Toni at gaano siya kabait, you still pray na magbi-break sila ni Paul. Ganyang klaseng tao kayo? That's the kind of supporters that deserve to win? No, your candidate does not deserve to win. Your candidate deserves to be banned at every possible position because pag kayo nanalo, it will proliferate toxicity, stupidity, and uselessness in our nation. Absolutely not. I will not allow it. So magtutuos tayo. Siguro kung si Toni G talagang mas nagagalit kasi wala siyang pakialam kasi maganda pa rin siya. And guess what? She may not host PBB, but can you imagine if she's our next spokesperson? 6 years of hello Philippines and hello world! Ready na ba kayo? I wouldn't mind that. I am so excited for her. It's either her or Christina Frasco na puro magaganda. So good luck. Can you imagine how well made our, media shorts for the president if BBM wins? My God, can you imagine Paul Soriano directing every one of those shorts for the PCOO? I'm so ready. Kasi makikita nyo naman yung difference, diba? Sinasabi nyo well-attended ang caravan nyo. Hindi kayo well-attended, be. Maliit lang talaga. Maliit. Yung place kung saan kayo nagtipon-tipon, kaya nagmukha kayong marami. Pero nagsisimula na yung live broadcast, hindi pa rin naayos yung teleprompter ng nanay nyo. Do you expect that to be the president of the Philippines? King peste kayong lahat. Araw-arawin ko talaga kayo ng peste kasi ngayon inaaway niyo si Toni G and that's personal. And by the way, kung ikaw ay isang artista na hindi ka nga makasabay sa dance step ng grupo mo, shut up. You don't have a right to be disappointed at Toni G. Hindi nga kami nagre-reklamo sa'yo eh. Simpleng dance step, di ka makasabay. At saka kung ikaw naman wala kang career pa sa ABS-CBN, you think na sisikat ka just by hitting Toni Gonzaga, shame on you. If you wanna make it in the industry, huwag ka mang apak. And aapakan mo si Toni G. Teh, abog ka lang kay Toni G. Please lang. Irreplaceable, iridescent, incredible, So don't. It's just the same with Katuning, and you hate him because he's on our side. You hate Tony G and Paul S, and you think that it only cements that we all agree, people of this caliber agree, that the definition of the better tomorrow for the Philippines lies in the unity, lies in BBM becoming president and Sara Duterte becoming vice president. A tandem when you know that is not ever going to fail at the election, no matter how much you cheat. So i-enjoy ko lang yung kape ko. And I'm sure ini-enjoy din ni Tony G yung araw niya na she's in the outside world.